It's been a minute since I called you, just to hear the answer phone. Yeah, I know that you won't get this, but I'll leave a message so I'm not alone. This morning I woke up still dreaming, with memories playing through my head. You'll never know how much I miss you. The day that they took you, I wish it was me instead. But you once told me, don't give up, you can do it day by day. And diamonds, they don't turn to dust or fade away. So I will keep you day and night, here until the day I die. I'll be living one life for the two of us. I will be the best of me, always keep you next to me. I'll be living one life for the two of us. Even when I'm on my own, I know I won't be alone. Tattooed on my heart are the words of your favorite song. I know you'll be looking down, so I'm gonna make you proud. I'll be living one life for the two of us. I can feel your blood run through me, you're written in my DNA. Looking back in every mirror, I know you'll be waiting, I'll see you again. But you once told me, don't give up, you can do it day by day. And diamonds, they don't turn to dust or fade away, fade away. So I will keep you day and night, here until the day I die. I'll be living one life for the two of us. I will be the best of me, always keep you next to me. I'll be living one life for the two of us. Even when I'm on my own, I know I won't be alone. Tattooed on my heart are the words of your favorite song. I know you'll be looking down, so I'm gonna make you proud. I'll be living one life for the two of us. I promised you I'd do this, so all of this is all for you. Oh, I swear to God you're living through everything I'll ever do. So I will keep you day and night, here until the day I die. I'll be living one life for the two of us. I will be the best of me, always keep you next to me. I'll be living one life for the two of us. Even when I'm just like we started, just you and me and no one else. I will hold you where my heart is. One life for the two of us.
Clear. Jesus. Oh, cause every sickness, oh, that is sent to destroy your health, oh, in the name of Jesus, is canceled. Yeah, yeah, oh, yeah, yeah. Cause every principality that come against your prosperity, oh, in the name of Jesus, is canceled. Every stronghold that come against your purpose, in the name of Jesus, is canceled. Oh yes, I believe. Cause you shall live, you shall live, you shall live. The enemy come to kill, steal and destroy, but God said, I come that you may have life and have it more abundantly. There's some traps that are set up against your destiny and your purpose, but I declare in the name of Jesus, you shall be the head and not the tail. We have the power to bind the force of darkness, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers. Follow me, let's pull them down. Everything that will try to harm you is canceled.
Brothers and sisters, and welcome to Uganda Baptist Church in Boston. I extend a warm welcome to all of you who have come to support the family of the Pottinger as we bid a Christian farewell to our brother Errol. We want to make sure that we are keeping up with the COVID protocols so that we don't have any hiccups of that nature or any other nature for that matter. So we'll try to start on time and do everything as prescribed by the government. At this moment, without wasting any time, we will want to start with the tributes. So those people who are giving the tributes, please come forward and we start. Thank you very much.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good. He believed that he could live life and live life with fullness. He was loyal. He was one who, no matter what, he always had your back. And as we come today to say goodbye, as he goes on for another part of his life, I want to say, let's remember him for his good deeds.
Reverend Father, members of the bereaved family, including myself, friends, all, this morning is a sad moment for the Pottingers. The visitation of the Lord in the Christmas season, in the way it's good. When I look at Errol's age, that was the time of his father's life on earth, grandfather's life on earth. So the age 49 is one that we revered in the Pottinger's line. My father died at 49. Errol is going home at 49. Errol was a joyful, loving son and nephew. And he endeared himself to all of us. My home and at his work. He had a lot of friends. And he lived a good life and was very supportive of his father. But the time has come that the Lord has called him. You see, we are all flowers in the garden, and the Lord picks as he chooses. Some as a tiny bud, some at mid full bloom, and some when the petals are falling. So he calls each of us at a funeral to really reflect of our own life and be thankful for what we have received and prepare ourselves, because this funeral has touched the family and relatives deeply. This is a visitation of the Lord and the Pottingers, because not long after we will be burying his father, and it calls for a lot of deep thinking. As flowers in the garden, God picks as he chooses. And so I looked at Errol in the coffin there, and it's just as I knew him. He was very close to me. He always visited me in St. Mary. I had a good time. And I think he was the strength of his father back home, having been in the same professional field as his father. And no stranger to these parts. I am deeply sad for the close relatives and his friends. And we pray that the Lord will receive him as a faithful son, dying in the field of the church which he belongs. And each one of us must take a reflection of our own lives and prepare ourselves for the past at some time. May the Lord bless Errol on his way, and may we all learn from this lesson, and may his soul rest in peace. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, we have heard a lot of good things about our brother Errol from his uncle and the person who spoke before him. Now we want to turn our attention to God, from whom all goodness flows. So we will begin the program with the blessing of the body. I ask the congregation to stand. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, to the love of God and the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all, my brothers and sisters. Amen. You know, this program is dialectical, priest and the congregation. So make it lively, make it spiritual, by making your responses. Hold the confidently, because now we are talking to God. Amen. Praise be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercy, and the God of all consolation, who comforts us in all our afflictions, and thus enables us to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from him. I bless the body of Errol with the holy water that recalls his baptism, of which St. Paul writes, All of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into him in his death. By baptism into his death, we are buried together with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness of his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness of his resurrection. On the day of his baptism, Errol put on Christ. On the day of Christ's coming, may he be clothed with his glory.
And at this moment, I invite all of us to sing together the entrance hymn.
Let us pray. Almighty God, our Father, we firmly believe that your Son died and rose to life. We pray for our brother Errol, who has died in Christ. Raise him at the last day to share the glory of the risen Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the reading.
Oh, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all fall asleep, but we will all be changed. In an instant, in the blink of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet will sound, the dead will be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For that which is incorruptible must clothe itself with incorruptibility, and that which is mortal must clothe itself with immortality. And when that which is corruptible clothes itself with incorruptibility, and that which is mortal must clothe itself with immortality. And when that which is corruptible clothes itself with incorruptibility, and that which is mortal clothes itself with immortality, then the word that is written shall come about. Death is swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sin? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise the Lord.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, and have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If they were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." My brothers and sisters, the gospel, the good news of our Lord. Then, please be seated. Good morning, my brothers and sisters. Once again, I want to extend my heartfelt condolences to the Pottinger family and all of you friends who have come to bid a Christian farewell to our brother Errol. Indeed, for the Pottingers, this is a devastating time, having lost two members of your family, having lost two of your beloved ones within less than a month. I've been praying for you since then, because I know how challenging this time is for you. And I continue to pray that God will give you the consolation and the strength that you need to cope. You know, my dear brothers and sisters, in a time like this, for a family like yours, there are no human words that can bring you the consolation that you need. But I'll tell you what, God's word is able. And I encourage you to listen to the word of God in this beautiful ceremony service we have for our brother, and draw from the word of God that consolation which your hearts yearn for. My brothers and sisters, there is a universal law. What did I say? There is a universal law. A law that all of us, a law that each and every one of us is bound to follow, not by our choice, but by nature's design. You know, anytime we talk about laws, principles, constitution, we start shaking because they tell us what not to do and what to do. And we don't like to be told what to do and what not to do necessarily. This law, my brothers and sisters, is no different. And the law is this: all that is born dies. What did I say? All that is born dies. It's not. It's the law, but it is what it is. 49 years ago, a baby boy was born. And that baby was Errol. There was joy all around when that baby was born. There was joy in the family. There was joy in the community, I believe. And there was joy in the church, Roman Catholic Church. And especially when that boy, Errol, was brought into the church to be baptized. I do believe that many of you remembers all of that except for one person, and that is Carol. And don't ask me why I'm saying this. Only Carol and I know why I'm saying this. Most of you remember all of that. My dear brothers and sisters, contrary to that joy, less than a month ago, death forced its way into your family. Death forced its presence into your family and brought sadness. Sadness. When Errol died, Mr. Pottinger came to me in Falmouth and introduced himself, and we spent more time talking and getting to know each other. And I was truly sympathetic to him, for him. I could see that sense of loss in him, but also I saw that courage in him to do what he has to do, and stand and accept what has happened, because he couldn't change it. That was clear in him when I'm talking with him. But the sorrow in his heart was inevitable. And that is what death brings. Birth brings joy, and death brings sorrow. The two are totally opposite in effects. My dear brothers and sisters, like I said in the beginning, the sorrow that death brings, the sorrow that I saw in the heart of Mr. Pottinger, who is not with us anymore, and the sorrow that I relate to in your lives, hey, guess what? I have also lost my dearest people, so I know exactly how I'm feeling. So that's why I'm very much with you in a time like this. And a sorrow like this, no human words can bring consolation to us. And there is always that question, why me? Why us? I'm sure the Pottinger family has asked that question over and over. It was a Sunday afternoon. And I have three churches, all the Catholic churches in the parish of Trelawney. I pastor them. One is in Falmouth, one is this one where you are seated right now, and another is in a refuge. So I do two services every Sunday, in the main parish and one of the missions. So that Sunday, I was right here. After the church service, I was just talking with the members, and then I hit the road, go back to Falmouth. And as soon as I reached home, that's the time to check my phone on a Sunday morning, at the end of the last service. And I pulled the phone, and I saw the message from Carol. Father, my dad is dead. It was a shock. But it was what it was. It couldn't change.
praying for them, and asking God to kindly and lovingly receive the sons, the Pottingers, the junior and the senior, and God will. Today, the gospel that we read is very consoling for you, my dear brothers and sisters. Jesus, in the Gospel of John, says to his followers, as he says to you, do not let your hearts be troubled. Your hearts are troubled, of course, and Jesus knows that. But what he's saying to you today, as St. Paul also tells us, that we who are believers, when we mourn, we should not mourn like the pagans, who are hopeless in a sense. They don't have any hope in the resurrection. For us, even when we mourn as a people who believe that after this life, there is a better life. There is a better life. And so Jesus says, do not let your hearts be troubled. Why? Because of the hope we have in that better life. The life with Jesus. Because when Errol was baptized, he was buried, plunged in the water, symbolically buried into Christ's death. When he was raised from the water, he's raised into the new life of Jesus, which he will share here and the life after here. And that life, my dear brothers and sisters, is a life that all of us who believe in Jesus look forward to. It's a life where there is joy because we will live in the presence of God. No sorrow, no pain, no cursing, no shooting. But joy, 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 endless joy. If we can only imagine that and believe in the words of our Savior. My dear brothers and sisters, the task is all of us to walk hard towards that life. Who will be those that will enjoy that life? It will be those who love God. Those who serve God. Those who live according to God's will for them and for our brothers and sisters. That love, that joy that we look forward to in heaven begins right here. There is nothing like a miracle. That joy begins right here. We have to work for it. We have to work towards it. And then Jesus tells us that if, my dear brothers and sisters, we make every effort to live a life pleasing to God, a life that gives honor to God and our brothers and sisters, a life that serves God and one another, then let not our hearts be troubled. You know why? Because even death, the greatest enemy that we have known on earth, death is the greatest enemy. But when we live our lives in Jesus, in God, even that enemy has no power over us. Do you believe?
Sure.
Let me hear you, man. Do you believe that when you live a life that is honored, even death has no power over you? That's my strength. I am a victor because my Savior is. You are a victor because your Savior is. But that's only if you believe. Right? And then your brothers and sisters, when our time comes in death, then there is no need to fear, because death is not our boss.
we live in him, our Redeemer is a victor, and so we are victors. And because we live and believe in Jesus, then we can sing our victorious hymn. We can sing our song of victory, which St. Paul in the Corinthians sing with us today. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin. But thanks be to God, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who has given us victory. In Jesus, my dear brothers and sisters, we have attained that victory. Victory over sin and death. And because of that, even now, our hearts can sing the hymn of victory. Thanks be to God, because I am a victor. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for us, his church, confident that God hears the voice of those who trust in the Lord Jesus. We join our prayers to his.
In baptism, Errol received the light of Christ, scattered the darkness, now and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Our brother Errol was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Many friends and members of our family have gone before us and wait the kingdom. Grant them everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Many people die in violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose fate is known to you alone. Lord, in our mercy.
Lord, hear our prayers.
The family and friends of Errol seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and discipline the darkness and doubt that comes from grief. Lord, in your mercy.
Lord, hear our prayers.
When we assemble here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Errol, strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of our son's coming. Lord, in your mercy.
Lord, hear our prayers. Lord our God, give our peace and heal our souls. Hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And as children of the same Father, and as brothers and sisters in Christ, let us pray as the Lord himself taught his disciples. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
Father, Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
May the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Let us share with each other a sign of Christ's peace by hands away. Please be seated for the meditation. Thank you.
is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Errol again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us again in joy, the joy of the kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Confident in our hope of eternal life, let us commend our brother Errol to the loving mercy of our Father, and may our prayers go with him. He was adopted as God's son in baptism, and he was nourished at the table of the Lord. May he now inherit the promise of eternal life and take his place at the table of God's children in heaven. Let us pray also on our behalf that we who mourn and are saddened may one day go forth with our brother to meet the Lord of life when he appears in glory. Saints of God, come to his aid. Angels of the Lord, listen to me. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
To your Lord we commend the soul of Errol, your servant. In the sight of this world, he is now dead. In the sight, he lives forever. Forgive what sins he committed through human weaknesses. And in your goodness, grant him everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living.
The Lord,
I love the Lord, for he has heard the cry of my appeal. They surrounded me, the snares of death, with the anguish of the tomb.
They brought me in sorrow and distress. I have called on the Lord's name.
How gracious and just is the Lord. Our God has compassion.
The Lord protects the sinful heart. As a little soul to receive him.
Turn back my soul to your rest, for the Lord has been good. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living.
Praise the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. I will walk in the presence of the Lord.
Errol, may the angels take you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you on your way and lead you into the holy city, Jerusalem. May the choir of angels welcome you with Lazarus, who once was poor. May you have everlasting rest.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto Errol, O Lord.
And let your light shine upon him.
May his soul and all the souls of the faithful depart, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen. This is my soul.
for granted when to hear your voice was just a call away. What I'd give for just some time to say the things that slip my mind. There's so much now I'd really like to say, but I can never go back when we did the things we did back then. I'll store those precious memories in my mind. I'll take what you've instilled in me. I'll try to be all I can be and walk the path that you have left behind. I sure miss you.
Life will never be the same with you not here. Each passing day has brought much pain. With God's grace, my strength remains.
I sure miss you, but heaven's sweeter with you there. The little things that seem so small are now like gold in a memory vault. I cherish every one I have of you. Now I can see and recognize the part you played to shape my life. I often see you in the things I do. In God's design, in my all the hurting hearts of men, as we would say goodbye to those so near. So with our family and friends, we'll be together once again. We'll view heaven's splendor hand in hand.
With you not here, each passing day has brought much pain. With God's grace, my strength remains.
I sure miss you,
the heaven's sweeter with you there.
If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you.
I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you.
Still with you.
You made it feel.
yalema ikayalami ilondoloze uhambe nami zungangishilana Jerusalema ikayalami ilondoloze uhambe nami zungangishilana dawu yami ayikholana mbuzo wami awukholana ilondoloze uhambe nami dawu yami ayikholana mbuzo wami awukholana ilondoloze
So we will wait until you put on your face masks and then we will open the casket. Or we will continue without resuming. Please respect the protocol. Thank you.
Praise to you, Lord of all creation. Praise to you, holy and living God. We praise and bless you for your mercy. We praise and bless you for your kindness. Blessed be the Lord our God. Almighty and ever-living God, in you we place our trust and hope. In you, the dead, whose bodies were temples of the Spirit, find everlasting peace. As we take leave of our brother Errol, give our hearts peace in the firm hope that one day Errol will live in the mansion you have prepared for him in heaven. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. The people say, thank you. Because God has chosen. Because God has chosen to call our brother Errol from this life himself, we commit his body to the earth, the deep, the elements, its resting place. For we are dust. And unto dust we shall return. God of holiness and power, accept the prayers on behalf of your servant.
Set him straight. Set him straight.
Do not count his deeds against him. And in his heart, he desired to do your will. As his faith united him to your people, so may your mercy join him to the angels in heaven. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the people say,
amen.
I ask the people now together to sing the choruses that we have in our program for this very place where we are.
When things like a river
Oh,
hush, hush. And the lightning crash and rise. No grave can hold my body down. No grave can hold my body down. No grave can hold my body down.
But that's not the song. That I know the way we are doing just playing.
Never mind,
no. We're not going to party just playing.
Won't it be a time when we get over yonder? Won't it be a time when we get over yonder? Won't it be a time when we get over yonder? Won't it be a time when we get
watching. She wants to see everybody.
Oh,
say hi to Karen.
Oh, hi.
Hi, Karen. Wish you were here.
What do you mean?
Peace and love. Wish you all the best, Cyril. We miss out to the crowd and the crew and the family. Yeah, my friends, see if Charlotte is here and everything. So wish everyone here a prayer and a prayer. Love is heavy, my brother. Respect. Good enough? One here. One has our respect.
But I take with me bone, I eat me bone.
I keep with money, with money. With
money. Oh, God!
Here to the front real quick.
For life, you and me in the wind. I never thought there'd come a time that our story would end. It's hard to understand, but I guess I'll have to try.
It's not easy to say goodbye. For all the joy we shared, all that time we had to spend. If I had one wish, I'd want forever back again. To look into your eyes and hold you when you cry. It's not easy to say goodbye. I remember all those great times we had. So many memories, some good, some bad. Yes, and through it all, those memories will last forever. There's peace in where you are. Maybe all I need to know. And if I listen to my heart, I'll hear your laughter once more. And so I have to say, I'm just glad you came my way. It's not easy to say goodbye.